grace, mercy, peace, the best of life is yours today and forever in Jesus Christ. Amen. Imagine your perfect vacation spot. Imagine your perfect vacation weather. Imagine your perfect vacation by ready to get up there and climb a mountain in the morning and then go rafting down the river in the afternoon. And then at night, ready to go to the restaurant and eat some more. Never be alone. Imagine your perfect vacation week. This last week wasn't one of those, was it? And not just the cold and the snow. Another week with another school shooting. Another week with colds and cancer. Another week with broken furnaces and broken bodies and broken homes. Another week of frustration. Another week of tears. And not just for us, but it was another one of those kind of weeks for God, too. Another week of really rejected and ignored, not just by strangers out in the street, but rejected and ignored by his own people, his own family. Another week of watching a world of brokenness and hurt and heartache, where broken and twisted hearts break and twist themselves and break and twist each other. Another week of hurt and heartache. Another week of frustration. Another week of, yes, painful judgment. Why? The soul that sins, it shall die. This past year, we know people who have died. We heard some of their names. I am sure that many, if not most of you, know people very close to you who have left this world this past year. Knowing that, you know some of their frustrations. You know some of their tears. And I would imagine that we share some of their same frustrations, that we share some of their same tears. Why? Life in this world is hard. And then what? And then we die. If you've been with us downstairs for Ecclesiastes in Bible class, that sure sounds a lot like Ecclesiastes does, because life is hard and then you die. But we have something better than just that this morning. Otherwise it wouldn't be such a great day. Today we get to hear God's answer for the frustrations of this world, God's answer for the tears of this world. We get to hear, yes, God's answer for death. And what does he say? Behold! In our frustrations, in our tears, he doesn't want us to miss this. So he doesn't just slide it in quietly. He says, behold! Behold, I will create new heavens and a new earth. Instead of the frustrations of this world, instead of the tears of this life, we get to look forward to a new world, a new life, a new home with our God. What will it be like? Our lesson says, the former things will not be remembered, nor will they come to mind. No flashbacks. No nightmares, no kicking ourselves. All our hurts, all our heartaches, all our failures, all our guilt, forgotten, gone and forgotten. Forgotten by God, forgotten by us, forgotten by whoever would want to remind us of that, completely forgotten, gone and forgotten forever. That's something amazing and wonderful to think about, isn't it? Forgetting. And what is forgotten? That guilt, the shame that gnaws at us, that haunts us, that has us beating ourselves up over and over, forgotten and forgiven in the blood of Jesus. Forgotten and forgiven, forgotten with Jesus. And our hurts and our wrongs, forgotten and covered over with the glory of Jesus. Also, here's God's promise. I will create Jerusalem. Now Jerusalem will be the city of God, so the people of God, that's us, you, me, the people of God. He says, I will create Jerusalem to be a delight and its people a joy. The sound of weeping and of crying will be heard in it no more. No tears in heaven. No grumpiness, no grouchiness in heaven. And God doesn't just say that we'll be happy in heaven, or even super happy in heaven. He says that we will be a joy and a delight in heaven. Sometimes in this old world, we're not. Is that fair to say? Sometimes in this old world, we can be a pain. I know that I can be a pain. But in God's new world, I won't be a pain. In God's new world, you won't be a pain. Instead, in God's new world, we will be so kind, so gentle, so understanding, so loving. We will have it so together that we will be a joy and a delight to God and to all the people around us. We don't all feel that way in this world, do we? Sometimes we might feel like we put people off. Sometimes we might feel like we put God off. But in God's new world, you won't see God's scowl. Instead, you will see Jesus smile. In God's new world, you won't see people trying to quietly get by you or try to sneak away from you and step back and move on. Instead, in God's new world, you will be a joy and a delight to everybody around you. And everybody around you will be a joy and a delight to you. In God's new world, every day, forever and ever, world without end. Room without end. Here is where our picture gets a little bit blurry, a little bit grainy. We had one of those digital TVs that we kind of a messed up picture. He says, never again will there be an infant who lives but a few days. Or an old man who does not live all his years. He who dies at 100 will be thought of mere youth. He who fails to reach 100 will be considered accursed. It almost sounds here, it almost sounds as if people will die in God's new world. But the point here isn't death, the end of life. The point is life, the longevity of life. In God's new world, you don't miss the revelation. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the old order of things will have passed away. In God's new world, death will be done with, and because Jesus lives, you too will live. Because Jesus lives forever, you too will live forever with him. When I think of life in this world, I don't want to live forever like life in this world. So what will life be like in God's new world? He gives us a people. They will build houses and dwell in them. They will plant vineyards and eat their fruit. No longer will they build houses and others live in them, or plant and others eat. For as in the days of a tree, so will be the days of my people. My chosen ones will long enjoy the works of their hands. They will not toil in vain, or bear children due to misfortune, for they will be a people blessed by the Lord, they and their descendants with them. In this old world, how do things sometimes work? Some days we work, and someone else gets the credit. Some days we work, and someone else gets the payoff, the benefit. Some days we work, and it seems that we go home empty again. Sound familiar? Here in this world, life can be so frustrating, but in God's new world, you will never go home frustrated. In God's new world, you'll never wake up wondering, why am I? But in God's new world, things will always work right for you. Life will always go right for you, and you will always be blessed right. That's pretty good, doesn't it? One more thing. The wolf and the lamb will feed together. And the lion will eat straw like the ox, but dust will be the serpent's food. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain. Hard to imagine, isn't it? The wolf and the lamb getting together. Hard to imagine here in this world. Is it safe to say that we all have enemies, or at least think or feel like we have enemies? Is it safe to say that it sure feels some days that we have people who are against us, and if not people, we sure have things working against us? And so sometimes in this world, we're afraid. Sometimes afraid of danger, sometimes afraid of what other people might do to us, afraid of what other people might think of us, and so we have our guard up, and we're keeping our guard up. In God's new world, in your new world, we won't ever have to worry, we won't ever have to be afraid, we won't ever have to worry about keeping our guard up, because there will be nothing, there will be no one to guard against. In your new world, you will live in perfect peace. Your heart, your whole being, perfectly safe. Sounds good, doesn't it? Sounds so good, maybe I think, come Lord Jesus, come quickly Lord Jesus, take me home now Lord Jesus. Well, we don't have to be in such a big hurry. Heaven isn't going away. And your place in heaven, it's not going away, it's not being taken away. No matter how many tears we might have in this world, no matter how many frustrations we might have in this world, your place with God in heaven is not the one to do it. What does that get to mean, Mark? We can wait. And we don't have to wait. We don't have to wait to find relief. We don't have to wait to rejoice. Even as we might cry out in frustration or cry out with tears, even as we might cry out, we get to rejoice. We get to rejoice because your God has a new day coming for you. Your God has a new home coming for you. Jesus has your name. Amen.